So, children, how are you? So, today we will learn solving equations having variables on both sides. And we will continue this linear equation in one variable chapter 2. And this is part number 4. So, how to solve when the equations having variables on both the sides of the equation. So, see children, one example, let us illustrate with one example. 3x plus 5 equals to 2x. Minus 3. Suppose we need to solve this question. 3x plus 5 equals to 2x minus 3. Now there are variables on both the parts. LHS also, RHS also. There are variables on the both the parts. So how to solve the equation of such type? So for solving such type equation, simply we know that we have to transpose variables on one side and constant on other sides of the equation. So here also we will do like this. We will transpose 2x here, and when we transpose, as we know very well that when transposing, the sign will change. Plus becomes minus and minus becomes plus. So plus 2x will come here, minus 2x equals to minus 3 as it is, and plus 5 will go there, and it will also change the sign, minus 5. If it is minus 5 there, then plus 5 will be there. But here it is plus 5, so when transposed, it will change the sign to minus 5. Now, 3x minus 2x, 1x or x simply, minus minus plus sign minus 3, minus 5 and minus 3 is minus 8. So see children, how easily we have solved an equation having variables on both the sides. Now let us solve exercise 2.3, and this exercise is just what we have studied now, that when variables are present on both the sides. Solve and check your result. We have to solve as well as we have to check it also whether the answer is true or not. So let's start. The question number 1, 3x equals to 2x plus 18. So here variable, here also variable. So we will transpose variable to one side. 3x. This 2x will come to left hand side, minus 2x. Now constant is present only at the one side, so it will remain as it is. It will not change. 3x minus 2x is x. X equals to 18. So see how easily we have solved the equation. Now let's check. Whenever we have to check, we have to take two parts, left hand side and right hand side. So let's start with left hand side, LHS. What is LHS? 3x. What is LHS here? 3x. Now put the value of x equals to 18 in this LHS. So 3x means 3 into x. Whenever no sign is there, that means multiplication is there. 3x means 3 into x. So 3 into 18. 18 is the 54. This is LHS. Now let's take RHS. What is RHS children? 2x plus 18. Now again put the value of x. What is x? 18. 18 to the 36. 36 plus 18. On adding again we are getting 54. So therefore left hand side equals to right hand side. Hence verified. We have verified also that we have done the correct solution of the equation. Now let us proceed to question number 2 in the same manner. What we'll do again? Again, we have to transpose variable to one side and constant to other side. 5t minus 3t equals to minus 5. Minus 3 will go there, plus 3. Minus 3 will go there, plus 3. We have to transpose variable to one side and constant to other side. And while doing so, the sign will change. 5t minus 3t, 2t. 2t equals to minus 5 plus 3 is minus 2. Minus plus minus. And put the sign of larger one. So larger one is negative, so minus 2. Now we need to find value of t. T equals to minus 2 divided by 2. Whatever in the multiplication with variable, it will come to division side. So t equals to minus 1. So we have solved the equation. Now let's check again whether we are right or not. To check, We again will take left hand side. There are two sides, left hand side and right hand side. So let's take left hand side. Left hand side is 5t minus 3. Now we are going to put the value of t in this equation, in this expression. T is minus 1, minus 5 into minus 1, minus 5. Minus 5 minus 3 is minus 8. Now let's take RHS. Right hand side is 3t minus 5. Again put the value of t. What is the value of t? Minus 1, minus 5. Minus 3 minus 5 equals to again minus 8. So see children, we are getting the same result. And if we are getting the same result, therefore left hand side equals to right hand side. Hence, we have verified that we are correct answer. So in this way we can solve, children. Now let us do question number 3. So in the same way we can solve again, transposing 5x plus 3x will come this side, minus 3x. 5, 9 will come here, minus 9. 5 minus 3, 2x. 5 minus 9, minus 4. X equals to minus 4 divided by 2. X equals to minus 2. So see children how we have solved. Now let's check the result. So again taking left hand side, let's check. To check we'll write like this, to check. Left hand side, what is left hand side expression? 5x plus 9. Put the value of x, what is x? Minus 2. 5 to the minus 10 plus 9. Minus 10 plus 9 minus 1. Now let's take right hand side. What is right hand side? 5 plus 3x. 5 plus 3 into x. What is x? Minus 2. 3 to the minus 6. 5 minus 6 minus 1. Therefore see children, both are equal. Therefore LHS equals to RHS. Hence verified. Now let's do question number 4. Question 4 is also of the same type. We have to bring variables on one side. So let's bring in, for that this 2z will come here, minus 2z. And this 3 will come here, 6 minus 3. 4 minus 2, 2z. 6 minus 3, 3. Z equals to 3 divided by 2. Now we can't cut, so it will remain as it is. Now let's check again, to check. We'll take left hand side. What is left hand side? 4z plus 3. Put the value of z. What is z here now? 3 by 2 plus 3 going 1. 2 1 za, 2 2 za. 2 3 za, 6 6 plus 3 is 9. Let's take RHS right hand side. What is RHS? 6 plus 2z. Z. What is the value of z again? 3 by 2. Put the value of z. So 2 to cut. 6 plus 3, 9. So see children, we have solved. We have one solution is correct. That means we are getting left hand side and right hand side equal. Therefore LHS equals to RHS. Hence we have verified. Hence. Now let us solve question number 5 of the same type. Let's solve. Again bringing variable to one side, transposing minus x and minus 1 transposing to the right hand side. 2x. This minus will come here, plus x. 14. Minus will come there, plus 1. 2x plus x, 3x. 14 plus 1, 15. X equals to 15 by 3. That means 5. So we got the solution. Now we need to check also. So let's check. To check, let's take left hand side. What is left hand side? 2x minus 1. Put the value of x. What is x? 5. 2 5s are 10. 10 minus 1, 9. Now let's take right hand side. What is right hand side? 14 minus x. Put the value x. What is x again? 5. 4a minus 5. 9. See, we are getting the same result. Therefore, left hand side equals to right hand side each equals to 9. So, hence we have verified. We are correct. Now, see question number 6. Something extra in it. So we have to solve it first, this bracket, then only we will transpose. So children, look here carefully this one. 8x plus 4, distributive property, multiply 3 with x and 3 with minus. 3 into x, 3x. 3 into minus 1, minus 3. Plus 7, going on there. It is outside the bracket. So range of 3 is these two terms only, x and 1. So we have multiplied 3 with x and 3 with 1. Now, 8x plus 4 equals to 3x minus 3 plus 7 plus 4. Minus 3 plus 7 is plus 4. Now, we have to transform the same form as we are doing in the beginning. From the beginning we are doing it. Now transpose 3x here and 4 there. When transposing, the sign will change as we know very well. Plus 3x becomes minus 3x. And 4 minus 4, 8 minus 3, 5, 4 minus 4, 0, x equals to 0 upon 5, whatever the multiplication will go in division, x equals to 0. Now we have to check also whether we are correct or not. So let's take left hand side. So what is LHS? 8x plus 4, put the value of x, what is x? 0. 0 plus 4, 4. Let's take right hand side. What is RHS? 3 into x minus 1 plus 7. Put the value. What is x? 0. 0 minus minus 1. 0 minus 1. Minus 1. 3 into minus 1. Minus 3. Minus 3 plus 7. 4. Therefore, LHS equals to RHS. So here also we have verified. Now let us solve question number 7. So see, question number is somewhat different. Here 4 by 5 into x plus 10. So we have to multiply. X equals to multiply 4 by 5 x. So 4 by 5 x. Multiply 4 by 5 with 10 plus 4 by 5 into 10. 5 1s are 5 2s are. Bringing variables on one side x minus 4 by 5x equals to 4 2s are 8. Now nothing is there, that means 1 is there. We can't subtract like this, so we have to make the denominator same. Denominators are not same. So take LCM. LCM is 5 multiplied by 5 both sides. 5x minus 4x by 5 equals to 8. 5 minus 4, 1x. And whatever in division will go in multiplication. 8 into 5. 8 5s are 40. So value of x is 40. Now let's check also. We have to check. Left hand side. What is left hand side? X only. So x is 40 only. Now let's take right hand side. 4 by 5 x plus 10. Now put the value. What is the value of x? 40. 40 plus 10. 40 plus 10? 50. 5 tens are 50. 4 tens are 40. So see, we are getting the same result. Therefore, left hand side equals to right hand side. Hence, well. Now, let's try to solve question number 8. How to solve question number 8? So, here, this is a variable part. This is also a variable part. Bringing variable part to one side. And constant to other side. While doing so, the sign will definitely change. Transpose. Now, we can't 8 subtract first, we have to make the denominator same, 3 and 15, LCM is 15, multiply by 5 both sides, 5 to the 10x minus 7x by 15, 3 minus 1, 2, 10 minus 7, 3, 3x by 15 equals to 2, 3 1's are 3 5's are. Now to find x, this is in division, so it will go in multiplication. 2 5's are 10. So value of x is 10. Now let's check whether we are correct or not. Let's check it. Left hand side. What is left hand side? 2x by 3 plus 1. Put the value, what is x? 10. 2 tens are 20. 20 by 3 plus 1. So again make denominator same. LCM 3. 20 plus 3 by 3. That means 23 by 3. Now let's take right hand side. Let's take right hand side. This is left hand side over. Now let's take right hand side. What is RHS? 7x by 15 plus 3. Put the value. 7x. What is x? 10. Put the value 10. Good. 5 to the 5 3. So, what are you getting? 14 by 3 plus 3 by 1. Make denominator same by taking LCM. 14 plus 3 to the 9 by 3. 23 by 3. So see, surprisingly we are getting the same answer. Therefore, LHS equals to RHS. Hence, verified. So we have verified also that when left hand side and right hand side are equal, that means our solution is correct. Now see question number 9, so the same type, again bringing variable to one side and constant to other side, 2y minus y will come here becomes plus y, 26 by 3 plus 5 by 3 will come here minus 5 by 3, changing the sign transposing, 2yy, 3y, denominators are same, no need to take LCM here. So we can directly add subtract 26 minus 5 by 3. 26 minus 5, 21 by 3. 3 1s are, 3 7s are. Y equals to 7 by 3, we are getting result in a fraction. So now let's check also. So again we'll take two sides to check. Left hand side, 2y plus 5 by 3. With the value y is 7 by 3 plus 5 by 3 going on. 7 to the 14 plus 5 by 3, denominator is same 3. 19 by 3. So left hand side we are getting 19 by 3. Now let's check right hand side. 26 by 3 minus 1. What is right hand side? 26 by 3 minus 1. Put the value again y, value y, value y 7 by 3. Denominator again same, and on subtracting we are getting again 19 by 3. Therefore left hand side equals to right hand side. Hence we have verified that we are correct. Now let's do last question of this exercise, question number 10. Again we have to transpose variable to one side, left hand side, 3m plus 5 will come here, minus 5m, and there is no constant on left hand side, so nothing will go on right hand side, only one part, minus 8 by 5. 3 minus 5 minus 2m equals to minus 8. Now minus 2 comes in denominator, whatever in multiplication it will go in division. Minus minus cancel, 2, 4 is 8, the value of m is 4 by 5, so we have solved. Now check, whether we are correct or not. To check left hand side, LHS 3M. What is M? 4 by 5. 12 by 5. RHS 5M minus 8 by 5. Put the value M. 4 by 5 minus 8 by 5. 5 for the 20. 20 minus 8 by 5. 20 minus 8? 12. So, see, we are getting the same result. Therefore, LHS equals to RHS. Hence, verify that we are correct. So, this comes to an end of this exercise 2.3. Understood, children?